Oh my god, this is panas. Ya Allah, panasnya.
I'm only saying that because he watches the same sheikh as me, and he says that anything that goes against the normal praying is an innovation in Dope. And Enu is different to the same prayer, and that's why I said Enuvation.
Lola.
He told me about churches. You can't build churches unless the whole village is.
You cannot be Minang if you are not Muslim.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Waktunya pergi ke Masjid Agung. Kita warna bajunya sabar.
Oh. Alright, sorry.
Masjid.
Ya. Yeah.
Masjid Agung Jawa Tengah. Guys, kami udah nyampe di Masjid Agung Jawa Tengah. Vlog kali ini agak sedikit lemah karena jam 12 dan tahu kalian tahu sendirilah jam 12 kayak gini. Jalan kaki di teriknya matahari.
And you thought you'd be able to walk all the way to here? We'd have been dead by the time we arrived.
Capek, Pak deh.
No.
Dia semalam udah ke sini. You already been here last night, right?
This morning.
Pagi tadi sama si Latif temannya, dan dia bilang sholat di sini beda katanya dengan dia di Inggris dan waktu dia di Padang dan juga di Tanah Suci. Saya nggak belum ahli dalam menjelaskan perbedaan itu. Mungkin nanti Bang Latif, dia juga lagi on the way ke sini, bisa jelasin kok bisa berbeda, apa sih perbedaannya?
Right. You'll have to tell me a bit about this place. That is Al Husna Tower, 99 meters. 99 meters.
Oh yeah, very big, it's massive. Sangat agung sekali.
Looks like the radio system.
You know what is agung mean? Agung means high.
Oh, high.
Respectful. As well, let's call Agung. Tiap kota kita
perlu. Talk about the mini kapal.
Ah, mini kapal.
Talk about the mini kapal.
Why? Ada payungnya kayak di Madinah, Masjid Nabawi, diresmikan pada hari Selasa 2006. Oh wow, really really hot. Ready. Panas.
Panas. Ya Allah panas ya. Aduh. Oh,
no, no,
oh my god,
no,
this panas. Ya Allah, panas ya. I need to take a break.
Oh,
you
tried it. Ini baru ah panas lantai ini. Gimana panasnya api neraka ya?
Ya Allah. Bener lah.
Calm. Where's your feet?
Oh aduh.
Udah dulu.
Ya Allah, panasnya masih berasa. Still can feel it.
Merah kayaknya.
Show me.
Yeah.
Oh. Yep. Udah. Hah? Ya. Yeah. Alright. Numpang sepatu enggak apa-apa sih, Nek? Gimana? Di dalam.
Iya.
Oh. Kasih ya. Tapi adem di bawahnya ini. Oh, dia. Yeah, kau. Just put yourself. Nobody.
I'll not be running across. Floors again.
That's not hell yet. Oh my god, memang benar-benar kebakar. Oh, that's nice. Is it nice?
Oh, yeah. Standing here for a minute.
Adventure, kau. Bakar, guys. Malam siang. It's malam. This young.
I was still a little scared.
Right there. I didn't go to the toilet. Where's Latif?
Inside probably. He hasn't replied, so I'm assuming he's private.
Yeah.
You can go and sweat
that
when you stand there for a minute.
Okay. In a bit.
Might even sit there.
Mine is still hot.
Yeah.
Honestly. Hey. Probably burn. Yeah. You're over. See? Burn. Oh my god. It's burn.
No. Happy files.
Udah aja gitu. You can swim here if you want. Alright, I'll go to the toilet first. Oh man. And you're still here?
Was your receipt here?
Hah? Enggak, kebakar. Kita lewat di paling depannya itu, di keramik itu. Jadi,
ya itu
panasnya.
Yeah.
Kayaknya 70 derajat atau 50 derajat.
Pas kematan juga pernah.
Oh ya? Pernah juga. Ini nih, masih kebakar nih.
Aku lupa, tahu.
Enggak, kami udah tahu sih. Cuman mikirnya enggak bakal.
Aku pinginnya belum tahu terus, Pak. Terus lari langsung.
Lari ya. Dia bilang tadi pagi dia sholat, katanya beda. Sholatnya di sini sama dengan di. What is the difference you said?
After the middle of second rakaat.
Setelah rakaat ketiga.
Kalau di Muhammadiyah enggak.
Muhammadiyah. Kenapa harus Muhammadiyah? Semuanya kan sama sebenarnya ya.
Iya kan. Biasanya kalau NU yang beda pakai kunut, Saudi juga.
Oh, gitu. Tapi nggak ada, there is no negative about it. It just an extra.
Ya. Yeah. So.
Dia enggak tahu. Ready? Yes. Besar banget. Besar banget masjidnya ya. Abang-abang enak kalau puasa-puasa kayak gini. Tidur-tidur di lantai, hobi saya banget ini. Berarti saya Indonesia banget. Iyalah. How many floors?
Six.
Dua. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Oh wow guys. Ntar guys, sholat dulu baru tak liatin. Tapi kok panas. Guys, tidur-tiduran. Tidurlah, Pak De.
Lie down. Why? You know what it's like. What, you're feeling wet carpet? What?
What?
I know.
It's nice carpet. It's not as thick as carpet. I've been on for other. I think I was spoiled with the Bowie carpet.
Nabawi carpet, yeah. Nabawi
carpet.
Carpet, Nabawi.
Is it
open?
That one,
yeah.
But
mm-hmm. It was open for the prayer. Because it was closed, wasn't it, when we went for it? In Mubarak, yeah. But because a lot of people from Padang City Centre, they're going back to their villages, not many people going to that mosque for praying.
Itu gara-gara itu
ya? Iya, orang banyak pulang ke kampung kan, jadi jemaahnya ya
nggak kira masih diperbaiki.
Enggak, nggak komplit kok. Aku rasa nggak gitu, cuman masjid-masjid lain kan juga banyak, yang dekat rumah orang kan.
Mestinya kan kalau orang masjid kaya yang dipakai pertama dulu, biasanya.
Kalau gubernurnya sih seharusnya kan sholatnya di sana ya kan?
Iya, betul.
Cuma mungkin gubernurnya lagi pulang kampung juga kayaknya.
Which, how long did it take to clean this carpet? To hoover it?
Hmm? Hmm?
You have a full day?
Maybe.
Just to
hoover
it?
Alright. Ini ngingatin aku waktu masa kecil nih lagi.
Apa yang
ada? Jadi pas belum puasa, sholat zuhur ke masjid, yeah. Atau sholat jumat, itu nggak balik-balik sampai jam 3 tidur-tiduran sama teman-teman.
Kadang main
tak umpet, ya kan?
Iya.
Sembunyi di toilet. Kalau nggak bermalas-malasan aja.
Iya.
Serius. Iya. Kalau sekarang mending main HP di rumah.
Iya.
Ya kan?
Well, then subuh takes about 3 minutes.
Yeah. 3 minute time? 10, sorry.
Two, 30 minutes.
Yeah, and then the one in the between?
One between?
Yeah, some pray or... Yeah. Not gonna be like after two. Oh, no. Tapi Relatif ada, aku pernah ke salah satu masjid di kampung.
Ya.
Sholatnya juga 20 kali. 20 rakaat.
Biasanya cuma
8. Itu cepatnya kayak petir. Malah lebih cepat dari kami yang sholat 8.
Aduh. Aku lebih suka sing 8. Nah, biasanya nyari masjid sing 8 kan bisa nikmati.
Jadi tapi enggak semua juga sih.
Iya.
Itu ada juga imam yang ustaz ya imamnya yang agak enggak tahu. Gimana itu. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Amin. Ya Allah. Ada juga kayak
di gitu. Demak itu masih banyak tuh.
Kayak gitu?
Masih banyak. Semarang mungkin 1 jam setengah untuk 23 rakaat. Sampai setengah 9.
Kembang Latif berapa rakaat biasanya?
23.
23 juga. You call? How many set tarawih? Dia belum ada tarawih ya? Di Padang lah nanti. In Padang.
You said you have to go to the mosque to do it.
No, I didn't say that. Yeah. Masa? Mana?
Kemarin pas tapi dah terlambat.
Enggak, memang harus di masjid kan enggak. Tarawih kan boleh sendiri.
Di musola boleh.
Tarawih sendiri juga boleh. Kalau
tapi lebih bagusnya jamaah.
Eh iya, maksudnya kalau enggak masjid enggak ada atau enggak ada imamnya atau kita punya halangan tersendiri atau kita lagi sakit ya, kalau kayak dia ini sebagai belajar dimanapun boleh asal asal jangan di tempat yang diskotik atau yang enggak, you know lah, yang halal lah gitu.
Benar sih,
saya tahu saya gitu ya,
biasanya harus jamaah kalau untuk
ya sih. Kalau Islam kan semuanya itu tergantung situasi sebenarnya. Gimana kalau kita lagi di ini, di taruh di mana ya, di Amerika atau di Iceland atau di mana gitu, kita nggak ketemu muslim boleh
iya.
Sendiri nanti lah tak ini India. Aku memang belum sempat ngajarin tarawih, salat tarawih. Tarawih is basically the same with the general salat call. Tiduran. You just they have a two option if you want. You want to do 20 time.
Di sana juga ada banyak tuh, yang
23. Dulu sih orang-orang lama-lama dulu ada yang 20. And then you can do 8 plus
three.
Both is plus 3.
Astronomical. An odd number, isn't it?
Hmm.
Yeah.
23 or 11. But why Latif say can be 3 hours? Because before Tarawih, we have a speech from imam, like asking question or something like that. Ceramah kan?
Iya. Emang satu
Tarawih itu 3 jam.
Satu juz untuk ibadah kayak di Madinah.
Satu sholat itu aja yang 3 jam.
Tarawih.
Tanpa ceramah atau segala macam.
Ya, ceramahnya cuma 7 menit.
Ya Allah.
Iya.
Di sini.
Oh.
Nah,
kayak di Madinah. Akhirnya kan satu jus, satu traweh kan satu jus, ya satu.
What call?
I said maybe it's an innovation.
Dia ini suka manas-manasin kita loh. Dia belum paham sebenarnya, yeah, jadi dia penasaran ya.
I'm only saying that because he watches the same sheikh as me, and he says that anything that goes against the normal praying is an innovation and don't do it. And NU is different to the same prayer, and that's why I said NUvation.
No lah.
NU is what I know. They have a mazhab that following siapa ya? Mazhab
Syafi'i.
Syafi'i. So.
Mazhab Imam for Imam.
For Imam.
Yeah, Syafi'i, Hambali.
Syafi'i. Maliki,
Maliki. Tapi
siapa
kan? Lupa aku. But Muhammadiyah don't have that. We don't have mazhab. Huh?
They don't follow any of them.
No, we don't have mazhab. Muhammadiyah more like... huh?
The fifth.
No, we don't have that. Muhammadiyah, I can say, is a lot simplifying away from the culture.
The pure.
Pure.
Yeah.
Benar gak sih NU kalau ada ziarah ke makam kayak gitu ada ya? Okay. We don't do that.
Tabur bunga juga.
Iya, yeah, kalau makanya banyak yang komen pergilah ziarah ke makam. We don't do that.
Muhammad, yeah.
Which is the Sheikh? Si Muhammadiyah.
Who?
Sheikh Muhammad.
Sheikh.
The Sheikh. Hasim. Wow,
Hasim. Oh, Hasim, yeah, yeah.
Agak kuat ini perbincangan, tapi kita nyantai guys perbincangannya. Tolong koreksi kalau ada yang salah. No, Muhammadiyah izin. Kalau nggak salah cuman nggak ada di setiap negara ya. Itu lebih ke organisasi ya, yang bikin persetujuan.
Kayak Sufi dan Sunni. Sunni dan Syiah.
Itu Sunni Syiah mas. Muhammadiyah kan Sunni.
Ya, maksudnya
kalau
di Indonesia.
Okay.
You just saying
Muhammadiyah Shia. Kayak Sufi sih. Enggak ah. Pure Sunni kalau Muhammadiyah.
Iya,
iya. Kalau di sini juga ada kalau meninggal itu kayak 3 harian.
7 hari.
7 hari, 40 hari.
100
ribu ya. Kalau kami enggak ada.
Cuma 1 hari, Pak.
Cuman dulu ada waktu aku masih kecil-kecil ada orang tua-tua gitu. Sekarang udah dihapuskan. Dulu juga ada di Padang itu yang kayak minta hujan, terus ada sembeli kambing.
Istiqor itu bisa.
Sekarang ini nggak ada. Nggak. Apa nggak dibolehkan? Pokoknya udah ditinggalkan yang kayak gitu. Nggak tahu. Jadi kalau udah meninggal ya udah takziah selesai. Semua itu diserahin sama ahli waris. Misalnya doa ya doa anak yang paling ini. Anak yang soleh. Itu aja sih. Modal kita kalau udah meninggal. Enggak ada nanti orang-orang pergi ke kuburan kita terus berdoa atau ini, itu enggak ada.
Tapi kalau tiap lebaran enggak ada tilik kubur gitu enggak
tuh. Yang bersihin sih sebenarnya ngunjung bersilaturahmi, tapi yang doa ini segala macam sih enggak, paling Al-Fatihah dari anak-anak, bacaan doa ibu bapak, tapi kita enggak ada ke kuburan orang lain. Yang misalnya kalau di Jawa ada ya yang namanya kuburan Sheikh apa gitu, ustadz atau apa, terus pergi ke sana gitu ya,
kiai wali songo
berziarah ke sana gitu. Kita enggak ada, makanya banyak orang-orang nyuruh aku pergi berziarah gitu. Kita enggak ada diajarin enggak gitu. Dan itu enggak, ya enggak termasuk dari bagian yang kita pelajari.
All Sheikhs are Sufi.
Sufisme.
Tapi apapun itu perbedaannya, tak masalah. So when you die, Carl, in here, they have like...
My ghost go to heaven.
Ceremony for 3-day ceremony, 3-7 ya?
Yeah.
7-day ceremony, 40-day ceremony, 100-day ceremony.
We recite for the orang mati ya?
The dead person. Dead
people.
With a surat, yasin.
And then 1,000 days.
50-day, 7-day.
Not in Padang.
And that's, you said that once somebody's dead, that's it.
In Padang, yeah. That's all.
You don't need to pray for them after that.
We don't need what?
To pray for them after that.
Yeah.
We do. As a kid, as a family, we pray for our... Yeah, that's the most important in our belief.
Tapi nggak pakai itu.
But we don't have like ceremony, no?
The flowers.
Flowers or...
So do you have the ceremony every, what, three,
three
seven,
days, ten, seven ten, days?
Until 1,000 days.
1,000 days. Oh. So there's no ceremonies for that. You just go and put them on there and go away.
Jelasin lah. Latif. Kenapa kayak gitu? Gitu. Nanti dia pemikirannya dia macam-macam loh. Tanya dia, you curious?
about Muhammadiyah and NU. You think isn't it? You think that we are competition?
Tapi mungkin belum
competition.
No.
Or did you say
that's what you think like?
No.
No. Basically, both is the same. But.
Well, apparently there's more to NU than there is to Muhammadiyah.
NU doing a lot of things like sunnah things. Mm. They do a lot kind of that things.
Sunnah things is NU.
Yeah. To. Something that not necessary they do.
Anyway.
And they like to have a reward. Mm. Orang NU kan suka banget dapat pahala kan.
Like I said to you, I'd like to see my book, my list of things that I need to counteract.
Yeah.
Dia inginnya cuma Islam dia. Tahunnya cuma Islam dia.
Iya memang di sana emang gitu. Hmm. Kita nggak ada kalau orang-orang di kita ke masjid sana, kan banyak orang Turki atau orang Palestine.
Names for different groups of people.
The group.
Oh no, sorry about
that. Yeah.
Orang India, orang Arab banyak di Liverpool.
I'm big fan, you're big fan.
Jelasin Bang Latif kenapa banyak ininya cabang dari Islam gitu. Hah? Kategorinya udah dijelasin.
Tapi mungkin belum tahu.
Do you know? Jelasin sekarang aku biar aku translate gitu. Kenapa why is so much different a bit between this and this? Hambali, Ikol Mazhab, NU, Muhammadiyah.
Mungkin bulan depan. Tapi aku udah janji.
I will explain to you.
It's to do with the Hinduism. We're trying to remove all the merging of religions.
No. That's totally not right. So I'm gonna say to explain to you, right? So Islam has two, Sunni and Shia. Muhammadiyah or NU or whatever, there is other four that follow Mazhab. They all Sunni. They all the same religion, Islam. Believe Prophet Muhammad is the last prophet, and then Allah, the only one God, right? Why they have different? Because when the friend of Prophet Muhammad, right, the witness what the Prophet Muhammad doing when he's alive, it's not everyone will see. So you have like sahabat, I would call it. Yeah, true friends. And this person seen Muhammad when he pray, he pronounce his sound Bismillah. Okay? But in Maghrib, for example, Prophet Muhammad didn't pronounce Bismillah. So both witness what Muhammad did. So that's why this one gonna follow this one, this one gonna follow this one. Right, so whatever NU doing now is based on what Prophet Muhammad did, which is the others didn't see it. Does that make sense? For example, you are Prophet Muhammad. Just example, you would not allow to say that. Just an example, okay? Just to make you understand.
Yeah.
And Latif is your best friend. Me is your best friend. And then you go to Surabaya and then you pray there. Pray like this. This like that, right? And then you go with me to Padang and then you pray a different way. I mean the same things, but for example you say you pray between the raka'at or something like that. So we both is right. Does that make sense? That's why different things. As long you not cross the border, for example. Like you
company
Yeah, like you believe or something that not in Al Quran, or you believe spirit that give you happiness, that's not allowed.
That's a matter of
right.
You go to a cemetery to pray, it's okay. You praying someone, that's all right. It's a good thing, but if you believe that person gonna make you more healthier, gonna make you more rich, that's not right.
Yeah, so basically what I was trying to say before you said it was wrong was
stuff like that. So if I'd have finished what I was saying about Hinduism, I have a strong belief in spirits and ethereal beings, it's a move away from that back to the pure Islam.
Why is it wrong? Because I don't want to touch to talk about Hinduism, because people in Hinduism sound like we are say they are wrong.
No, I wasn't about to say that at all. What I'm saying is a merging of the two religions. So Padang doesn't really have a big Hindu existence or a big Hindu influence. It's the right word to use. Whereas the further east you get towards Bali, it's more and more Hindu, isn't it? It's more and more Hindu.
Believe it or not, we are probably entire Indonesia Hindu and Buddhas, because when we pray in Padang, I remember when we were a kid, we burn kemanyan, which is a small wood or whatever is coming from. It smells so stink. I remember that.
But whether I believe it or not, it's visually a fact. But the further east in Indonesia you get towards Bali, the more Hindu things still exist.
Okay, you might not wrong, but the
More Hindus.
The reason is Islam is coming from the north of Sumatra.
Yeah.
Arabic.
Arabic.
Yeah, it might be the Arab not really fully spread the Islam toward to the east of Indonesia. That's why Banda Aceh is like Serambi Mecca. That's where the Islam coming from Indonesia.
Yeah.
And then Bukit Tinggi, Padang. That's why they're more something like that. And if you probably right, if you went to the end island of Java, which is Banyuwangi. Banyuwangi is a lot of Hindus in there. It's like Bali. Yes. You know what I mean? Yes. But then after Bali, if that your theory, Lombok is the closest one to Bali. They're Muslim.
Muslim, yeah.
Island's a little bit different. An island is a small pocket.
Yeah.
So once one starts to change, it spreads a lot easier than an island because it's a small population. Big island like Java, really long. Takes forever to get from one side to the other. Back in the years when you didn't have cars and bikes and planes, the Hindu influence took a lot longer to go away. And as we get more towards modern society that's more accepting of everything, the harder that will be to move away from it and to one main religion in the island of Java, because it's massive.
It could be. I think it's more like how strong Islam influence in that area.
Yeah.
People still have a Buddhism. Latif.
Apa kan?
Orang Buddha kan di Jawa Tengah. Banyak kan?
Di Magelang banyak.
Yeah. And that where is the Borobudur?
Yeah.
It's that. There's very little of any in Padang. That I saw. It wiped out Hinduism, didn't it? And any other religion that tries to exist there, unless there's a huge number of them, can't exist. You told me about churches. You can't build churches unless the whole village is Christian.
Well, not the whole, I never say that. You can build your own place to pray if enough people in there, because there is in my village there is no Christian or one or two, and then if they build a church like this, so what is the point? But in Padang city center, a lot of Christian churches in Padang city center, because they need place to pray. We have to respect them. Why Padang or Sumatra Barat is a Muslim very popular in Asia, Padang and Aceh. Sumatra Barat, West Sumatra, is the culture is based on Islam. Adat Basandisara,
aksara basandi kitabullah, which is Minangkabau. If you Minangkabau, you must be Muslim. You cannot be Minang if you are not Muslim. Like you now, Carl. You can be Minangkabau. Because the main because you the main reason to be the main requirement to be Minang is have to be Muslim. Cannot be other religion. So if you, for example, if you are now Minang and then you change your religion to other religion, you're not Minang anymore.
It's not an ethnicity then.
Huh?
It's not an ethnicity then.
I think they do.
What do you mean?
It's not an ethnicity then.
The Minangkabau?
Yeah.
Minangkabau is not ethnic.
It is.
It's an identity. If it's an ethnic, you're born as Minang. You cannot become anything else.
No.
It's not an ethnic.
You can be Minangkabau if you move to West Sumatra. Right, if you join the society, you can be one of us. It's not like Jewish. You can be, you're only Jewish if you're born as Jews. No,
you can convert to Judaism,
but they don't.
But
so many
in Israel, they don't believe it.
Yeah, they don't believe it. That's what I mean. But you can be Minang, but
it's an identity.
No. The way you can be Minang because we respect people who come to our place, to Minangkabau. Because like we're gonna have ceremony in the Minangkabau, you can join us. You know, you can marry Minang people and then you become Minang.
Yeah. Good for you.
Yeah. But like Javanese people, if they come to Minang, they're not gonna be.
That's right.
You can be, ya. Boleh. Jadi banyak orang Jawa jadi orang Minang. Karena mereka nyampe di Minang, mereka beranak, mereka punya keturunan. Semuanya jadi orang Minangkabau. Nggak masalah.
Ya, udah Indra.
Hah?
Udah Indra.
Udah Indra mana?
Suaminya
Umi. Oh, Minang asli itu.
Apa sih kayak itu Jawa
tuh? Ya, Latif said he's a... It's like someone who come to Minangkabau. No, it's origin.
His family's in Jakarta though. Did they move over there?
They move over there, yeah.
Asli Minang gitu.
Asli.
Sama jenya kayak Jawa itu.
Kayak Jawa, ya. Banyak di kampungku orang Jawa, orang yang transmigrasi kan. Mereka nyampe di ini, mereka udah beli tanah, udah jadi orang sana. Jadi orang Minang.
Biasanya Jawa itu ke Jambi, daerah Karet itu biasanya.
Ya, orang Minang nggak terlalu.
Nggak Karet ya?
Nggak. Orang Minang nggak terlalu ketat dengan suku selama masih Islam. Minang is not really
straight
to about the ethnic.
Yeah, means something different in Indonesia. I've come to learn.
Yeah.
Ethnic.
Yeah.
Because what you are describing to me, in the traditional sense of the term ethnic, is like saying a black person come from Africa, move to Scotland and say I'm white now.
Yeah, you cannot just like that.
I know ethnicity.
You.
In the proper sense.
You living there, you have a
definition.
Grandchildren or something like that in there. You know, but in the end, if you're asking the black guy, come to my village, where you from? And then he will say he's from Africa. And then he say, but I'm in Minang now. That's how it's now. It's not like black and white. That has happened in environment, in life. You cannot just say A is A, B is B. I'm proud being Minangkabau like that. It's more open, but some people like murtad, something like that. They Islam and then they become as a other religion. It's fine, but you cannot push people to accept you as a Minang.
Nah ini guys, bentuk dari Masjid Agung Jawa Tengah.
di Semarang. Ini di dalamnya, kami habis tidur-tiduran. What you think the most that day? Very nice.
Second time I've prayed in the one in Padang.
Yeah?
Never prayed in that one.
It was
closed.
So we go
to
that tower.
Take me to it.
What mana? Towernya?
I want shoes on. I'm not walking across that again.
No.
Panas lagi
tuh. Udah pada tepar semuanya. Nah, this is a Bedu, the one you heard from when we were in Istiqlal. Boom, boom. It's like counting down. Boom, boom, boom. Probably only in Indonesia.
It sounds like Star of EastEnders when you do it like that.
Dum, 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 dum. Allahu Akbar. Atas towernya guys, 9 tingkat katanya. Abang Latif nih. Oh, beli tiket dulu. 10.000. Oh, naik lift.
Lantai 19
dulu ya? Iya. Itu turunnya bisa lantai
3
sama 2. Oke.
Oh, 19.
19
ke atas. Ya, 19. Black coffee ya.
The perfume name.
Oh, fresh air.
Fresh air. Fresh air. That's a window fresh air.
Jadi lantai 19 toh. Yeah.
There's a lift course. Okay.
Kita berada, oh bisa lihat
yeah.
Ini bukan masuk masjidnya kita bayar pakai, yeah. Ini kita cuma di tower dan towernya dekat di masjid. Tapi nih kita bisa lihat, wow, pemandangan di sini di kota Semarang. Nah ini kita berada di lantai 19. Nah, bisa lihat nih. Gak perlu drone lagi saya nih. Bisa lihat.
So, scared?
No. Wih, anginnya kencang banget di sana guys. Dan kita mau ke Mimsu.
Bawa enak.
Hah? Kopi. Bawa enak. Wasabi. Wasabi.
I like to smell.
Yes.
And this one. I mean,
it
comes out and I go.
Bau kopi ya? Yeah. More like chocolate,
isn't it? It's because it's not made from actual coffee, it's made from chicory or something like that.
Mm. Yeah, that's a coffee flavour too.
Yes.
Nah, ini museumnya di lantai 3. Ulama dan santri. Ini senjata-senjata Jawa ya, keris. It's a weapon. Wiggly, ya. Traditional weapon.
Just to make the hole bigger, bigger, bigger.
You can try. Put in your belly.
No.
In marriage.
Oh, yeah.
Slip in.
Yeah. Slip di celanamu.
Yeah.
Langsung sunat kamu.
Better not.
Ini apa nih?
Tentang kayak untuk
kasidah.
Yeah.
Oh.
Sudah lama cuma
ini
sudah
juga. That's how it's like
instrument.
Yeah, instruments
from
kasidah
music.
Yeah.
Yeah. Terbang
is this one, the instrument
call it
terbang.
Terbang. Bisa diterbang gitu.
Nah, terbang.
Rebana kalau biasanya namanya.
Iya. Yeah. Di
sini tentangnya. Oh. Oh ya nih, kesenian rebana. Gendang kalau ini. Oh, this is 100th beauty mosque in Indonesia. Ada yang di oh. Pastilah gue nyarinya yang ada di kampung gue ada gitu. Belum ya? Jakarta sama Madura, Gorontalo, Jakarta.
Oh, see that this one is right in the first.
Yeah. Oh,
that was nice.
Yeah. Kalimantan, ini Purwi.
It's in Kalimantan?
Yeah. Kalimantan Selatan. South Kalimantan.
South, yeah.
South.
Istiqlal.
Istiqlal is nice from the inside. It looks a bit plain compared to what it is now on this page. But it's just a square building. A whole thing. Where's the one by the
The gun. Masjid Nur Hakim. Oh yeah. It's not even built yet when this is released. Masjid Raya Padang's not here either.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no, that one's not.
Belum. Mungkin belum.
Masjid Raya Padang yang ini. Katanya terindah di dunia.
Indonesia.
Ya? Yeah?
Translate
in Japanese. Oh, kedudukannya. Oh. Yeah. Easy.
Oh, it's good to sit on the floor.
Yeah, oh, sitting on the floor, yeah.
Sutra. From
Kali.
Chinese and Islam.
Arab. Multicultural. Kita di dalam ini nih sekarang, lantai 3. Guys, payungnya dibuka kayak di Medina. Apa deh?
Oh, yeah.
It's lucky us. No. Boleh? Oh wow. Ah. kayak di Madinah guys, payungnya. Nah, ini adalah Quran terbesar yang dibikin oleh Mushaf Bar. Veteranus ditulis oleh veteranus saya, Mr. Saints Quran. Nusobo dari kampungnya Sibiyangan. Wow. Nusobo kan. How you think, Al? Amazing, isn't it?
Tidak, aku kagum juga. Iya. Langsung ke sini tadi, Pak.
Ini terbesar di dunia atau apa?
Enggak, di Jawa Tengah.
Di Jawa Tengah.
Besar.
Wow. Ayo.
Ramadan.
Oh, dibuka.
183. Apa tahu? 183.
Jadi ini besoknya dibuka lagi pas Idul Fitri misalnya ada ini.
145 cm lebih dari 1 meter panjangnya. Luasnya 95.
Spasif, Nek. People, we need that.
What's
that? So you can learn quickly. Because you're taller.
Still the same amount of words on a page. Imagine trying to get that on an airplane. Oversized baggage, sir. There's a £100 bill.
Ya, yeah. Wallah wahad bisa.
Iya, yeah, serat pendek.
Alik kelas. Kayaknya saya kuallah wahad, Kal.
Yes.
Really?
The favorite one.
Favoritnya dia juga. Favorit kita juga, kan? It's our favorite as well.
Kul hu.
What a shot.
Kul hu wallah.
Kul hu allahu ahad allahu samadu.
Allah.
Lam yalid wa lam yulad. Wa lam yukulahu kufu anahad.
Sometimes, you know, when you say Allah, it's more like Allah, okay. More like a bit heavy. When you say Allah, it's
like
more
light. Yeah.
Allah. That's what I want.
W-H-L-O-H.
As you say Allah, it's very light. Allah.
Maybe in another 30-something years, I'll get there.
Yeah.
So it'll take forever.
You can take... Can take it for entire our life, ya kan? Belajar agama, learning religion or Islam is entire your life until you dead. Nobody. Yeah. Like me too. As long you keep learning, that is the main thing.
Trip kita di Semarang, you satisfied? Yeah, yeah. Enjoying? Looking like to as well?
Yes.
I mean in Semarang.
Ah,
I thought you meant the
bus. Yeah. You're enjoying your time in Semarang? Yeah,
personal bike rider. Would you recommend for tourists to come to Semarang?
Just
call
Latif and he'll drive you around.
Really?
Maybe just
for you, special for you. It can't be that special. Because Latif was a shy guy. Anyway, saya memang surprised banget. Yang paling highlight saya adalah clean, bersih, tertata. Besar tapi bersih, tapi nggak tahu di pojok-pojoknya saya nggak tahu ya, tapi yang jelas semua yang saya kunjungi alhamdulillah bersih dan patut contoh untuk orang lain. That's my highlight. Kalau of course Masjid Agung Jawa Tengah.
Waktun Nuwun Mas.
Oke.
That's it. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and thank you so much buat Pak.
Sama-sama. Bang Latif, thank you so much lagi.
Yeah,
okay. Pelukanlah.
Yeah.
Kau.
Terima kasih.
Terima kasih.